Hello everyone. Now let us solve some more problems by this conjugate beam method. So this is the problem. Now determine the slope at A and B and maximum deflection for the loaded beam as shown in the figure. He has given the values of E and I. So if you draw the bending moment diagram, you know that it is just simply supported by carrying point load at the center. So bending moment diagram is just WL by 4. That is WL is 4 divided by 4 means it will become 10 kilonewton meter. So when you draw the bending moment diagram, EI will not bother. But when you draw the M by EI diagram, you need to divide by EI of the corresponding section. Now if you convert this bending moment diagram into M by EI diagram, so you know that first is 2EI, 10 by 2EI, that will become 5EI. Then this divided by I. Previously I was first, next was 2I. Now here it is first divided by 2EI. 10 by 2EI, 5EI. Then 10 divided by, that is EI, that is 10. So 5 to 10, it goes to 0. So this is the loading diagram. M by EI diagram is given. Beam will become loading diagram for the conjugate beam. This is the conjugate beam. The end conditions remains same and the span also remains same. Only here, the loading diagram for the conjugate beam will be the M by EI diagram for the given beam. Now, to calculate the VA and VB for this conjugate beam, first, we have to take the areas and the distances easy because you have to take the moment of these areas about the B. This is a loading diagrams are loads are now these areas. So here if you take this area, A1 equals to half base into height, that is 1 by 2 into 2 into 5 by EI, which comes 5 by EI. Then X1 bar with respect to B, because I want to, when I take the moment about B, we calculate VA. So it is from here to the CG of this, it is 1 third of base, that is 1 third of 2, plus from C to 2, you have to add 2 here. So it is 1 third of 2 plus 2, it will become 2.67. Next, this triangle, that is 1 by 2 into base is 2, height is 10 by EI. So if you simplify this, we will get 10 by EI. Next, X2 bar means from here, it will be 2 third of base, that is 2 third of 2, it will be 1.33 meter. Now, to calculate reactions, what I need to do is, I will do sigma MB equals 0. This is VA into 4 minus this load into distance of CG of this load to B. This load is nothing but A1. The distance of CG of this load number 1 to B is X1 bar we have calculated. Similarly, this load is A2, that is a half base into it. The distance of CG from here will be X2 bar we have calculated. Just if substitute the values of A1 X1 bar and A2 X2 bar, so you will get VA equals to 6.66 divided by EI. Now therefore VB equals to, by writing sigma FY equals 0, VA plus VB equals to total downward load. What is total downward load? Area of this triangular load plus area of this triangular load. So that will become, area of both the triangles if you add, it will become 15 by EI minus VA, that gives you 8.34 divided by EI, that is nothing but the reaction at support B. Now, slope at A for the given beam is equal to, you know that it is shear force at A for the conjugate beam. Shear force at A for the conjugate beam is nothing but the reaction at A, that is VA. So theta A is the slope at A for the given beam, VA is the shear force at A for the conjugate beam, which is equals to 6.66 divided by EI kilonewton. Similarly, to get the slope at B for the given beam, you have to calculate shear force at B for the conjugate beam. That is theta B equals to, again it is minus VB because we are coming from right end. So it will be minus the VB we have calculated as 8.34. It is minus 8.34 divided by EI kilonewton. Next, here it is asked to calculate the maximum deflection. So if it is symmetric loading is there, we can call maximum deflection occurs at the center. But the loading is here unsymmetric. So initially we don't know where exactly it will be the maximum. So therefore what we need to do is, we have to assume let bending moment be maximum at a section at a distance x from support B. Let us assume one section here at a distance x from B. Let us assume that the bending moment will be maximum here. So what is the relation between the bending moment and shear force then? Where the bending moment is maximum, there it will be, the shear force will be zero. That means now we said that let bending moment be maximum at this section. Therefore automatically what happens, the shear force at this xx will be zero. Now if you write the shear force equation at this section, now I will consider this portion. It is minus 8.34 divided by EI plus this much triangular load. What is that? Half base is x, height is 5x by EI. So if you simplify this, so you are going to get here x equals to 1, 1.826 meter. See, again this height of the triangle can be calculated from the similar triangle from this, because this is 10 by I, this total is base and this base is x, this is height. So 10 by 2, that is nothing but 5 into base, that is x. So it will be 5x divided by EI will be the height of this triangle at the section xx. Now, once if you get the value of x, that is the position of the maximum bending moment or the position of the zero shear force. Now, we need to calculate the maximum deflection. What is that maximum deflection for the given beam is? Maximum bending moment for the conjugate beam. You know that y maximum, where it will be maximum bending moment? It will be at xx. So now, if you come from here, it is 8.34 into x, right, minus the moment due to triangular load about this section. It is 1 by 2, base is x, height is 5x by 3i. This is the triangle load. And what is the distance of CZ of this triangle from xx? It is 1/3 of base, that is 1/3 of x. Now, if you substitute the value of x equals to 1.826 meter and the value of EI which is given, you will get here y maximum as 0.385. meter. Now let us consider one more problem here. This is determine the slope at A and deflection at center for the beam. You know that it is loading is symmetric, but EI values are different. If you calculate the reaction for this, you know that central symmetric loading WA, that is RA equals to RB equals to W by 2, that is total load by 2. So RA will become 50 kN and RB will become 50 kN. I mean, if you calculate the bending moment at C, it will be RA into, that is 3, RA into 3, or it will, can say WL by 4, 15, that is 150 kN per meter will be, kN meter will be the bending moment at C. Automatically bending moment here will be RA is 50 into 200, similarly here this side RB into 2, that is 100. But now this is bending moment diagram. Now we need to, as EI is different, you have to calculate M by EI diagram for the conjugate beam. This is the conjugate beam of same length, that is 6 meter. Simply supported beam remains, end conditions remain same. Only this diagram will have to divide by EI, so that this diagram will become the loading diagram for the given beam. Now here, 100 by I, that is I is I, so 100 by EI first. Then at this junction it goes to 2i, that means the same 100 divided by 2i, it will become 50 by i. For this, now it is totally 2i, so 150 is in the portion between this to this, which is having 2i as the i. So 150 divided by 2i, it will become 75 by i. And similarly here, this first is 2i, then it goes to i, that is 100 by 2i, it will be 50 by i. Then 100 divided by i, it will be 100 by i. So this is the symmetrical, here also symmetrical, so here also you will get a symmetrical loading on this conjugate beam, but now it will be a area loading. Okay, now to calculate the reaction for the conjugate beam, it is symmetrical loading. You know that previously, you know that it is a symmetrical loading. So this VA equals to VB, that is equals to total load divided by 2, or directly I can calculate area on the half portion. Right, area on the half portion also it is same as total area divided by 2. So now we'll take here only the area between A and C, because it is a loading is the areas. So as the loading is symmetric, VA equals to VB, now that is equals to total load by 2, or you can say VA equals to VB, that is total load on half of the span, that is between A and C. Now this area we have to divide into two parts. This is one triangle, this is a trapezium. I am dividing into one triangle and one rectangle. Now again here A1 half base into height, that is 1 by 2, base is 2, height is 100 by EI. Then X1 bar means with respect to C means from here to here it is 1/3 of 2. Next you have to add 1. So it will be 1/3 of 2 plus 1, it will become 1.61 meter. Similarly A2 is this, 1 by 2, base is 1, height is, see this you know that here previously this was totally 75 by EI, right, and this is 50 by EI. So total 75 and this is 50, so it will become 25, triangle height is 25 by EI, and if you simplify that you are going to get 12.5 by EI. The next two bar with respect to C will be here, it is 1/3 of the 1, 1/3 of base of this second triangle is 1, so it will be 0.33 meter. Now A3 is rectangle, this is 1 meter, this height is 50. So it will be 50 by EI. X3 bar means as it is a rectangle, CG lies at the center, base is 1 meter, 1 by 2, that is 0.5 meter. So therefore now BA equals to VB, that is equals to total load by 2 or half the load. Half the load means it is nothing but A1 plus A2 plus A3. So if you add the areas of all three parts, you are going to get the reaction as 162.5 divided by EI. Now, to get the slope at A for the given beam, you know that it is shear force at A for the conjugate beam. So theta A is the shear slope at A for the given beam. VA is the shear force at A for the conjugate beam. Shear force, just now we have calculated as this VA as 162.5 divided by EI. Now he has also asked to calculate the deflection at C. Now deflection at C for the given beam is equals to the bending moment at C for the conjugate beam. C is nothing but center here. So it is bending moment at C for the conjugate beam. So deflection at C, let us call it as a YC. Now let us calculate bending moment C for this conjugate beam. So VA into 3, that is VA into 3. Next, this area into distance of CC, that is A1 X1 bar. This area into distance of CC of that with respect to C, that is A2 X2 bar. Then minus A3 X3 bar, that is area of number 3. We have already calculated A1 X1 bar, A2 X2 bar and A3 X3 bar. If you simplify by putting these values, you are going to get here YC equals to 291.375 divided by EI. This is what the deflection at the center or at point C for the given beam. Now we will take another problem here. It is a cantilever. Determine the slope and deflection at the free end of the cantilever beam shown. So this is the cantilever. So first you need to draw the M by EI diagram. What is that? First you have to calculate for the given beam bending moments. So here bending moment at C is 0. Next, bending moment at B, that is 30 into 3, that is 90 kilonewton meter, right? Then bending moment at A will be this 30 into 6 plus this 60 into 3, that is 360 kilonewton meter. But when you want to draw the M by EI diagram, first this bending moment at B is 90 by EI. Then next, divide by 2 EI, 90 by 2 EI means it goes to 45 EI. Bending moment is here 360 kilonewton meter divided by area of this portion is I. 360 divided by 2I is 180 divided by EI. Now this diagram is negative because all the bending moments for the cantilever are negative. So whenever the loading diagram, so bending moment diagram is sagging, the load diagram we take it as downward. Now this is a bending moment diagram is negative, so therefore we take the load diagram as upward. Now here, in case of simply supported beams, always end conditions remain same. That is, simply supported remain in real beam and conjugate beam remains same. Hinge remains same, roller remains same. But here in cantilever beam, the fixed end will become free end, and free end will become fixed end. This is the property of the conjugate beam, and the M by EI diagram will become the loading diagram. And as this diagram is negative, so the direction of the load is upward. Now here, he has asked to calculate the slope and deflection at the free end. Now for conjugate beam, so let us calculate these areas first. This again I am dividing into three parts. This is 1, 2, 3. This is area number 1. It is 1 by 2. Base is here 3. Height is this much. What is this height? Total height is 180 minus 45. So 180 minus 45 will be 135 by EI. So you will get here 202.5 divided by EI. Then X1 bar with respect to C. Because when you want to calculate deflection at C, we have to take the bending moment at C. Therefore, the distance between this and the C is required. So it is from here to here, it is 2/3 of base, that is 2/3 of 3 plus 3. You will get 5 meter. Next, this is a rectangle. A2 is 3 into 45 by EI, that is 135 by EI. Then distance of CC of this rectangle from the C will be, from center to here it is 3 by 2 plus you need to add 3, so it will become 4.5 meter. Similarly, now this is the area A3, that is 1 by 2 base into height. Base is 3 meter, height is 90. So if you simplify, you will get 135 EI. The next 3 bar with respect to C will be here 2/3 of base, that is 2/3 of 3, it will become 2 meter. Now, so this is the conjugate beam already drawn. Now what is the slope at C for the given beam is nothing but shear force at C for the conjugate beam. What is shear force? It is nothing but the algebraic sum of the vertical forces. Here all these are vertical forces. So area number 1 plus area number 2 plus area number 3 will give you total shear force at C. So this is nothing but here. yes, shear force is nothing but the all the three areas. Area of, that is this area will load number 1, load number 2, load number 3. So the areas if you add, you will get here 472.5 divided by A, because already we have calculated A1, A2, A3 separately. Otherwise, this triangular area plus this rectangular area plus this triangular area, you can write, you can add, that also you will get 472.5 divided by A. Next, to get the deflection at C for the given beam is nothing but when you want at C for the conjugate beam. Again, how to calculate the when you want at C for the conjugate beam? This area multiplied by x1 bar, this area multiplied by x2 bar, and this area multiplied by x3 bar, because load multiplied by distance. So here yc is equals to, because the areas are minus here, so a1 into x1 bar minus a2 into x2 bar minus a3 into x3 bar. Already we have calculated a and x values, and if you simplify this, you are going to get here minus 1890 divided by ei. This is the deflection at C for the given beam, and the deflection at C for the given beam is nothing but bending moment at C for the conjugate